A disgraced sheriff who is now out of the Arapahoe County jail that bears his name. A week after his arrest, Pat Sullivan is out on bond. The accusations against him leading administrators to reconsider who gets their name on local landmarks. We are also learning more about how Sullivan helped one man with a questionable past get a job inside a school. With more on the former sheriff's release, let's check in with Eric Connert, who is near Sullivan's home tonight. Eric, what can you tell us?
Well, we have not seen the former sheriff return to his home here this evening. All the lights are out. We have been here since he was released from jail. The HOA asked camera crews not to be on their private property, which is why we're standing where we are here. He was dressed in a black trench coat and he used a black cane this afternoon when he was released from the jail bearing his name. Sullivan didn't answer any of our questions. He got into a green Toyota 4Runner and took off. The 68-year-old bonded out after his bail was reduced from $500,000 to $50,000. Sullivan is facing a misdemeanor and 3 felonies, including charges for drugs, influencing a public official, and soliciting a prostitute. He's expected to face a judge again in January. Also today, 9 wants to know, learn new developments involving Sean Moss, the 27-year-old whose body was found in a river near Coors Field last January. Moss's boyfriend says Sullivan did drugs with Moss and was with Moss the night before he died, and that the two men met at a gay lounge. Back in 2007, Moss was able to get a security guard job with the Cherry Creek School District, where Sullivan was heading up the security. Well, on Moss's application, under former employers, 9 wants to know, has learned Moss listed an adult sex toy shop and a gay lounge. He had no prior experience as a security guard. When we asked the district if there was any concerns regarding Moss's past employment, the spokesperson told us, quote, back then, when Pat gave you something like a recommendation, it would have come highly regarded. We looked at that through a different lens than we are now. After repeated requests for interviews, we still haven't heard from Sullivan's attorney or any of his family members. Information, Mark, in this case is going to be a lot tougher to come by now that the judge has issued a gag order. We will be here regardless, though, trying to get Sullivan's comments on these very disturbing allegations.
All right, Eric Connert reporting live tonight. Eric, thank you very much.